This tutorial shows you how to calculate the minimum required sample size for the two-way ANOVA with G-Power. When we start G-Power, we get this overview by default. We now need to select the two-way ANOVA first. Select it via Tests, Means, Many Groups, ANOVA, Main Effects and Interactions. Now you have to select the type of power analysis. Since you have to calculate the minimum required sample size in advance, you have to select a priori. The first input parameter needed is the effect size f. The conventions for the behavioral sciences 0.1, 0.25 and 0.4 for small, medium and large effects are shown as a tooltip taken from Cohen 92, a power primer. If you have research field specific thresholds though, or effect sizes from preliminary or comparable studies, use those instead. Other studies usually report an effect size of Eta squared. You can calculate f from Eta squared and vice versa using the following formulas taken from Cohen 88, pages 281 and 284 respectively. The second input parameter is the alpha error probability, which is the probability of committing a type 1 error. In short, this is the probability of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis. 5% is the typical convention, 1% is a bit more restrictive. A value above 5% should be avoided though. The third input parameter is power. Power equals 1 minus the beta error probability. Beta error is the type 2 error. In short, this means falsely retaining the null hypothesis. 95% power is typical, meaning you have up to 5% type 2 error probability. In some research fields, 0.8 is used here. This means you automatically accept a type 2 error of up to 20%. If you have power lower than 0.95, this usually calls for a reasonable justification. The fourth input parameter are the degrees of freedom. We know that in an ANOVA, the degrees of freedom always equals the number of levels minus 1. With a two-way ANOVA and its two factors, however, it is the number of levels minus 1 per factor multiplied with each other. For example, my first factor has 3 levels, my second factor has 5 levels. I therefore multiply 3 minus 1 by 5 minus 1, i.e. 2 by 4, and get 8 degrees of freedom, which I enter here. The fifth and final input parameter is the number of groups. In a two-way ANOVA, this should be pretty obvious. Multiplying the levels of the two factors with each other results in the number of groups. To stay with the example, factor 1 with 3 levels and factor 2 with 5 levels, multiplied with each other, results in 15 groups. Finally, hit calculate to see the minimum number of observations needed for the two-way ANOVA to detect the presumed statistical effect with the predefined type 1 error probability and power. As a rule of thumb, a smaller effect size and a larger power require more observations than the other way around.